Good morning and welcome to the 25th meeting of the Rural Affairs and Island Committee in 2023. Apologies have been received from Beatrice Wishart and Jim Fairley, and I welcome Christine Graham to the meeting, who is attending as a substitute. Karen, Rhoda and Christine are all participating remotely this morning. Gives us all a bit more elbow room. So before we begin, can I remind those members using electronic devices to please turn them to silent. Our first item of business is consideration of consent notification for three UKSIs, the Plant Protection Products Miscellaneous Amendments Regulation 2023, the Official Controls Established Lists Regulation 2023, and the Phytosanitary Conditions Amendment No. 2 Regulations 2023. Do any members have any comments on any of the notifications? No. Are members content to agree with the Scottish Government's decision to consent in the provisions set out in the notifications being included in the UK rather than Scottish subordinate legislation? Thank you. The committee will now consider the first EU law tracker report. This report was commissioned by the Constitution European External Affairs and Culture Committee to provide an analysis of developments in the EU law and a Scots law. The intention is that this would enable the Scottish Parliament to monitor the Scottish Government's commitment to regulatory alignment, and there's an expectation that subject committees will consider each EU law tracker report. The clerk set out the four case studies which relate to our committee, the Rural Affairs and Islands remit, and proposes the committee writes to the Scottish Government to ask a number of questions. Do the members have any comments on the EU law tracker or reports? No. Are you content that the clerks write a letter to the Scottish Government with a number of questions? Thank you. And that concludes our business in public. We'll now move into private session, and I suspend the meeting for a short comfort break.